Alright, so in this video we're going to do another proof, and this time it's asking us to prove that a function f is a bijection. So this is a really common type of problem that they give you in a first semester class of analysis, and basically it's a little bit formulaic in that once you learn how to do it, it's pretty much the same thing no matter what function they give you and no matter what ranges and domains they give you. So the three things that you have to prove to be able to prove that a function is a bijection is that you have to prove first that a function is well-defined. So they're going to give you a function, and I've never seen it not be well-defined, but you have to just prove it anyway to prove that it is actually a function. Then you have to do another two things. So there's a theorem that says that if a function is a bijection, it's surjective and it's also injective. So you have to prove that the function is well-defined, surjective, and injective, and then you can conclude, because it's surjective and injective, that it therefore must be a bijection. So we're going to do that, and it also doesn't matter which one you do first. So you want to prove that it's well-defined first, but then if you do injective first or surjective first, it doesn't matter. So let's go ahead and get started. So to begin the proof, like I said, we have to prove that the function is well-defined. So to do that, we just have to show that for the given domain of x, which is, in this case is 0 to 1, we have to show that f of x maps to 2 to 4. So we have to show that the domain and ranges match up to what you expect. And so we're given that x belongs to 0 to 1. So we're going to say if x belongs to 0 to 1, then we have, and this is just from the definition of what that means, it goes from 0 to 1. So then what you're going to do is just manipulate this inequality until it looks like 4 over x plus 1, and that just happens to be f of x, and then you can prove that f of x goes from 2 to 4 if you do this correctly. So we're eventually going to take the reciprocal to get 1 over x, but first we want to add 1, so we're going to add 1 to the inequality, so that equals that. Then we are ready to take the reciprocal, so 1 over 1 is just 1, and when you take the reciprocal, you have to flip the signs. So 1 over x plus 1, and then the reciprocal of 2 is 1 half. Usually I will skip that step and go ahead and rewrite it so that it continues with the signs on the same side. So I would rewrite that as less than x plus 1, which is less than 1. And then we're going to multiply by 4 to get the numerator of 4 over x plus 1. So that's going to be 4 times 1 half, which is equal to 2, which is less than or equal to 4 over x plus 1, less than or equal to 4. And that, not coincidentally, is equal to f of x. So we have therefore proved that f of x belongs to 2 to 4. So the first part of the three parts that we have to prove is finished. So we can say, thus we have shown that the function is well defined from 0 to 1 to 2 to 4. And the next thing we're going to do, the next thing I did was prove that it's injective. If you wanted to prove next that it was surjective, again, that's fine. So I'm just going to say next we will show that the function is injective. So when you want to prove that a function is injective, you basically follow these steps. You're basically going to show that if you have some variables x and y, and they're in the same domain, if you have that the functions are equal to each other, therefore x of y are equal to each other, if you can prove that, then you've proved that the function is injective. So we're going to say, suppose some variables x and y belong to the domain, which in this case is 0 to 1, and f of x equals f of y. Then we have, so f of x is equal to 4 over x plus 1, and f of y would be 4 over y plus 1. So now what we want to do is simplify this and manipulate this so that it can equal x equals 1. So we're going to take the reciprocal, so that's going to be x plus 1 over 4 equals y plus 1 over 4. We're going to multiply by 4, so that equals x plus 1 equals y plus 1, and we're just going to subtract 1 from both sides. So we have x equals y. So that was pretty simple, and we went ahead and proved that f, the function, is injective. So we're going to say, thus we have shown that the function is injective, and I usually put from 0 to 1 to 2 to 4 because we don't know technically if the function is well defined through all the real numbers. So you want to say, okay, we've only proved injectivity on that domain and range. So next we will prove that the function is surjective. All right, to prove surjectivity, I have another graphic that describes it. So I'll place that there. Basically, what you're gonna do is you're gonna, again, suppose you have a y, and this time it's gonna belong to the given range, and you're going to define a variable x naught, and you want to show that if you plug in x of naught into the function, it's going to equal y. And therefore, you're going to show that x of naught belongs to the domain and f of x equals y. So let's go ahead and do it. So we're going to say, suppose a or some y belongs to 2 to 4 and define x of naught. So here we want to do something on scrap paper, which is not going to be in our proof. And we want to find that if we plug in something to here, we're going to get y. So just the variable y. So what I mean by that is that we want to show that if we plug in something 4 over x plus 1 equal to y. So we want to transfer x to be equal to something. So let me just show you what I mean. We're going to take the reciprocal, so that means 1 over y, so that's x plus 1 over 4, multiplied by 4 again, so we get 4 over y, and then subtract by 1. So this is going to be our x of naught, and you don't want to include all this work in the actual proof. Just do that. You're going to see later on that when you plug it in back into the function, it'll obviously reverse what you just did and you'll get y. So you're going to get, 4 over y minus 1. Okay, so we have that sentence that sets up the rest of the proof. So we're going to say, then we have, by definition again, that y is between 2 to 4. And what we're going to do is manipulate that back to x of naught being equal to 0 to 1. So it's similar to what we did before. So to get to x of naught, we're gonna do first the reciprocal. So it's gonna be 1 half, flip the signs, 1 fourth. And like I said, I usually skip that step and go ahead and rewrite it back to the signs pointing the same way. Then we're going to just take, multiply by 4 actually, so that's going to be 1 less than 4 over y, and we're going to subtract by 1, so not surprisingly, that gets us back to the domain. So we have that this is x of naught, and we've proved that x of naught belongs to the domain 0 to 1. And we're not done yet. The next thing we have to prove is that if we plug in f of x, this is equal to y eventually. So we're going to say that f of x equals to f over 4 over y minus 1, which is equal to, and we're going to plug in x of naught into f of x. So that's going to be 4 over y minus 1 plus 1. This should be, I guess, x naught. So plus 1, that equals to 4 over 4 over y, because the 1 and the negative 1 cancel out. That equals to 4 times y over 4, which cancels out, which equals to y. So that wasn't too difficult either. So we can say, thus we have proved that the function is surjective for any y that goes from 2 to 4. And to finish off, we're just going to say by definition, because we've proved it's well-defined, injective and surjective. Voila, we have proved bijection. So we're going to say, because a well-defined function is bijective if it is injective and surjective, by definition, we have shown that the function is a bijection from 0 to 1 to 2 to 4, and we're done.